joke. I was flying back. I'm reading Men's Health magazine. Great magazine. Very informative. I get to the middle of the magazine. There's a full two-page advertisement. More than advertisement, I'd say it's a product launch, because I've never seen this particular grooming product for men before. And the best way I could describe it is deodorant for a man's undercarriage. Yeah, ball deodorant. Really? How bad are your balls gonna smell? Hey Bob, some of us in the office have been talking to you. Your balls smell so horrific, it must drift down your pant leg, come out the bottom, leave a trail of stench. So bad, the rest of us can't concentrate in the cubicle. We're all chipped in and got you a case of apricot ball deodorant. Please, use it liberally. Are you kidding me? Really? Ball? You trying to sell me ball deodorant? How'd you like it if you're reading Cosmopolitan and you come across an ad says, hey girls, tired of smelling like the door of an old tuna boat? Try new twat stick. Three delicious flavors. Yeah, well that's how I thought. I'm violated. My ball smells none of your business. Chili, and I wash it down with a cup of Starbucks coffee, and I'm farting like a circus oven. I got news for you. There's not enough apricot ball deodorant in that tube to make this area smell like. You know it's going to smell like apricots and ass. Is that what you're going for? You know, I can finish the blow job as long as it's a hint of apricot mixed up. If you want to blow me, I'll jump in the shower and Irish bring them up for you. But I'm not putting a fucking apricot ball deodorant. If you are, you might as well come out of the closet like a Murphy bed. Because men are supposed to smell a little funky. Work hard. Besides that, men don't behave like that. Men don't put on body creams and lotions. It's really a woman's game, really. Don't think us men aren't aware of the Herculean effort you women go to. Oh my God, is it Herculean? You know, the average woman will go through 6 pounds of lipstick in her lifetime. She'll spend 2.5 years of her life sitting in a salon chair getting her hair cut, dyed, blown out, and styled. She'll spend another year of her half of her life at home trying to recreate the same look. She'll waste a year of her life just trying to figure out what to wear. Then there's the plucking of the eyebrows, drawing them back in with a pencil, the gluing on the false eyelashes, the collagen in the lips to make them bubbly, the Botox and the crow's feet, the breast augmentation, the spray-on tan, the shaving of the underarms and the legs, the manicure, the pedicure, the waxing, the bleaching, the $800 shoes, the $600 dress. I mean, why don't you just try being a nice person? My ball hair back once a month when I happen to be an authentic individual. I don't have an agenda. We've lost our minds.